of people believing, discussing and propagating about paranormal things are not considered to be normal people by the normal society. There must be a scale for fixing normalcy. Then we have to go beyond the scale of comprehensibility to fix what is paranormal, what is normal. Before understanding paranormal and normal, we must understand that there is something infra-normal or below normal. I used to always say to people, most of the things are appearing to be paranormal because, abnormal because, you are below normal. If we are below normal, even normal things will appear to be paranormal. And those superstitious things are overwhelmed by deep insight, either in scriptures or in scientific pursuits. And by even the normalcy of a macroscopic happening, that may be normal to all, but a person who is below normal, for him it will be abnormal. So it is a comparative study of normalcy and abnormalcy. Whereas the phenomenal study of paranormalism is entirely different. So you have fixed it at paranormal phenomena. That which is phenomenally paranormal. Normalcy means that which is possible by a person's physical, mental, intellectual, collective, federal, committed and instrumental efforts. That which is subjected to. It includes also scientific temper, scientific innovation and instrumental support. That which is possible for a person to comprehend. It does not denote a person who cannot comprehend at all. If there is a weightlifter in age where there is a person who cannot lift even a feather, that does not mean that the person is paranormal and the person is normal. This is accessible for a person on the basis of a person's robust nature of the body by bodybuilding exercises, diet or nutrition value. There are proper other exercises which are comprehensible as well as accessible for people of the same caliber. So person having physical or deficiency in the home, that is what we call homogeneous standard. In the whole homogeneous standard of the same species, he cannot claim that that is paranormal and this is normal. So normalcy, it is the maximum potential output, MPO you have to say, maximum potential output. Persons who have claimed their intellectual precision by innovative approaches, like scientists, they are also normal human beings. As we are not scientists, we can see them as paranormal. Persons with sharp precision in mental center, in comprehensibility, in propagation, promulgation, skills of oration, etc. There are a lot of such people. Generally, we used to claim a lot of people, each and everybody. That is certainly something known as paranormal and God-gifted. As we are totally twisted and not gifted, each and everything that we cannot access, that we least bother about access or attainment, that appears to be gifted paranormal. Even if somebody, normally a child's power, ability to learn and to reproduce is more worthy. A first standard student, a proper studious student with proper nutrition, care, concern and training, easily they can totally recite the 700 shlokas of Bhagavad Gita. 6 years is more than sufficient. It is just for all people. But somebody is so then immediately it is considered prodigy, it is simply God's. No, not God, he has given his gifts in all forms. But a special feature of paranormalism is very rare to be distinguished from normal things. Really, absolute paranormalism is entirely different. I'm going to classify them later. What we want to say here is maximum potential output is there. In the same world, lot of the feeble creatures who are in a tremor, tumor and terror, suffering in the world, in the same platform, skillful people, impudent people, audacious people, bold and brave people, they are there. In the same world where there are filtered and sponsored idiots, great intellectuals and contribute to scientists are there. In the same world where beauty people, nutritionally insufficient people, those who are feather lifters or breeze lifted people, in the same platform, that of other robust people. We want to take them as a scale for normalcy, not these people. Maximum potential output. So, normalcy is defined as the utmost capability within the possibility of potential output of a person's physical, mental and intellectual status. Taking this as normalcy, we have to explain what it is. abnormal or paranormal. Whenever we go to the paranormal scene, we have several kingdoms. Paranormal scene within universal experiences and experiences. Paranormal scene in individual experiences and experiences. Paranormal scene that is within the collective society reflected between various people. And paranormal scene in its utmost enthronement of hierarchy, starting from God. Even God, as he is not comprehensible by a person's intellectual, physical and mental status, the hierarchy of paranormal scene starts with God. So God, number one. Number two, we are all just bulk of biological matter. And as a matter of consciousness, we have a bundle of instincts. Apart from which, understanding that there is a soul, that is also a paranormal phenomenon. If you consider that there is something soul, which is different from DNA, genes, chromosomes, sense and tissues, then certainly that must have some distinguishable feature. What is that? That is eternity. If it is eternal, why do we die? Because of transmigration. Why you are not going to be transmigrated? Because of karma. What is karma? To start and when does it end? It is perpetual. So this has created a trio known as God, soul and karma, the bondage. So this is the starting point of religious and philosophical paranormalism. So this starts. Then after the paranormal things are there. Even there are some families, I know that if their children just get a pass in their examination, that is a paranormal phenomenon to students. If those people, they are quiet in the house, obedient, suddenly it appears to be paranormal. It is not individualistic, it is not comparative, it is not just personally motivated or disciplinized, but it is phenomenal. The second thing is, I have already told about God, karma and soul. It starts with, everything starts with power. What is paranormalism or what is God, what is soul and what is karma? Everything is a power. What is power? Power is a force which directs something as a principle. Either with the will of the person, consent of the person, or even if it is not there, it is far beyond a person's acceptance and denial, subjection and refusal. So power is any driving energy unit that takes, acts, activates and conducts a mechanism in its course of activity. So God is also a power, karma is also a power, soul is also a power. The power of your soul is to do acts and to be binded by that. The power of karma is the repulsive and responsive action cycle of a person's deeds, which is having the ability to drive the mechanism of soul as per the previously committed imprints. God is a person who puppets everything. This is what the philosophy or religion claims. So it is power. Paranormalism is study about power. Even normalism, it has power. But absolute power, abundant power, inexhaustible power, ineffable power, transcendental power is studied in paranormalism. Limited power, executive power, collective power, federal power, supportive power is read in normalism. So paranormalism, it deals with a different type of study which starts with power. Now let us start with the understanding of three major schools of thought of power. One is power of thought, second is power of belief or faith, and the third is power of will. These three things rule in religion or in spirituality or in the society. Thought, which is known as conation in English, and sankalpa in Sanskrit, that is the power of God. When he thinks, it happens. If a person thinks that something must be done, according to the processing technology, the thought is exhibited either to a second person who is delegated to carry on the act by a process, or the person himself matures with the thought to be translated into action by his own executive skill. If I want to have some water, the thought drink water, either I must reveal it as a oral command, request or beseechment by which somebody brings water, or I must utilize the tools of grasping, the tools of lifting and the tools of reception like mouth, then I must take this water and drink. So the processing unit or the processing mechanism of a thought converted into a fruitful action is normalcy, direct connection between thought and effect without the intrusion necessity of any process in between is known. Accomplishment or supernatural power. Supernatural power, difference between supernatural power and natural power is, supernatural power has only two units or two stages. One is thought and second is a fruit. And in between, in normalcy, there is a mechanism known as execution. It may be mechanical, it may be scientific, it may be technical execution, and it may be the joint execution of various people, it may be a self-motivated execution. So that is the difference between these and these. Those who are in need us. A process in between thought and fruit, they are known as baddhas. Those who do not require a process of execution in between the thought and fruit, they are known as siddhas. It is the difference between siddha and baddhas. This is the philosophy that describes this paradigm. The second is the power of faith or belief, deep-rooted belief. Somebody used to say that mere faith is powerful, mere faith is useless. Faith blended with truth. If a person with a deep-rooted faith is taking cyanide to be elixir, it is not going to save the person. Must be having some truth. If you are faithless with the truth, and if your faith is truthless, both of them will not bring the desired result. So that is the faith of belief, that is in religion. Then the power of will, the power of will, commitment, mental sturdity. We used to see it even in non-religious. There is nothing known as non-religious. Everything is religious and everything is divine. Whether that is latent or obvious, it is a question. We used to say only the persons, those who worship God, they can have the nature revealed, because nature is the painting of God. It is the work of God. It is the skill of God. So if a person is an atheist, how he can become a scientist? It is possible because of two reasons. Persons accepting God in different dimension, they are also thieves. I don't accept a God that is in a temple, but I accept a God, I accept the truth, eternity, purity, etc. That is conceptive acceptance of divinity. And second thing, even if a person does not accept or care about these things, the janmantara asthitya, a person's time immemorial divinity or divine ordinance or subjection in his history, births and its continuity will reveal the nature. So even atheistic scientists, they have their scientific innovations made fruitful by their Esther millennia or Esther birth divinity and divine practices output, without which they could not have done that. It is the definition, reconciliation that has been given in the scriptures. So paranormalcy, it starts with the power of thought, the power of will. If you just think, that is thought. If you just make a deeper thought, that is known as will. If you just cling to somebody or something, it is something known as objective surrender. If you catch hold of something, that is faith. If you catch hold of something for benefit, that is known as a will. And if you just think, thinking is what we call it, the threshold of mind. Thought process is the spark of mind. And the spark of mind becomes rooted when it becomes faith. When it becomes more potentialized, it becomes will. So in the hierarchy, in the ascending order, thought is the starting point. Then thought becomes deep rooted when it becomes faith. Faith becomes potentialized or liberated when it becomes will. These three things are power. For greater persons, even thought is powerful. For mediocre persons, their faith is powerful. The will is powerful for normal people with a sturdy or strong commitment. So this is how we have to study these three major powers. And the problem is, now we have to understand four major steps. If there is such a power, number one, first question is very simple. Does power exist? We are seeing a lot of things. We have seen even the power soap, which is very famous. And there are a lot of products in the name of power. Does power exist means, we know gravity, we know electromagnetic flux, we know lot of other powers like atomic power, hydraulic power, thermal power, electricity, lot of these powers and their various utility services we are enjoying. Apart from this, is there any power which is worthy of not application, reapplication, but by prayer, by worship, by invocation, by ritualization, by realization, is there some sentient power? All of these powerful elements are insentient. Is there any power? That is existence. Number two, even if let some power exist, whether that power is materializable or not, I want something. Can I get something through power? Is it accessible and materializable? That is the second question. Third thing is, even if somebody possesses power and materialization, is it subjected to transmission? Is it transmittable to somebody else? So the existence of power, the transmission possibility of power, between which the materialization policy of power, they are subject to skepticism. Then how to understand that power and how to gain that power, how to apply that power, how to restore that power, these things are the normal questions. Whenever you are conducting any seminar for any person, these things are there. Is the subject matter apprehendable? whether it is applicable or not for us. Can we access it? Or even at the time of its depletion, whether it is restorable or not. So all of these things are there. Sir, I am purchasing a product. If I just spend it, where can I get it back? Where can I purchase and stock it? These things are very normal in even commodity purchase. So we want to get the real idea of understanding the manufacturer, the distributor, the stockist, and the agencies of the power of paranormal phenomena. This paranormal phenomena, just let me give some exemplifications of paranormal phenomena. Number one is psychokinesis. Just know they have read. Psychokinesis is action, activation, and acceleration of mechanisms by thought. Sankalpa matrena, yantrana manushyanancha, akarana karana anyathakarana samarthata uchyate. So technology of consciousness is a project that has been taken by Dr. Shadharu Ranade of Pondicherry Aurobindo University, by which like auto writing, how to make a pen write, and how to make a typewriter automatically type, and how to make a mechanism either to act or to activate or to be accelerated. If it is doing 100 words per minute, it will do 500 words per minute. So increasing the potentiality into 5 times, multiplicity, upgradation, more precision. So this thing is known as psychokinesis. Then second thing is insta assimilation. Immediately assimilating anything. For example, if there are 500 pages of book, to just copy inside a CD, it will not take the same time which is being taken for you to read and to assimilate. Likewise, intra assimilation and insta assimilation, extra assimilation and exo assimilation. To take something to your deepest mind and to have, it is known as adhita smara. It is known as intra assimilation. Inter assimilation is just squeezing, just as you are getting from somebody some coconut or fruit or garland, just to squeeze up the knowledge of a person and take a copy inside your mind. Just to download the message or the memory of an external brain of a capable person and to upload the same thing inside your brain is known as inter-assimilation. Exo-assimilation is from a library, from stored palmy scripts, from museum, everything etc. Immediately get those pages or get those necessary elements, immediately copy them and reproduce. This may be even transient or permanent. If you don't want to hold all of these things, you will keep it in bubble memory. If you want to keep it for eternity for propagation, that will be in your perennial or permanent memory. So these are the various skills. Then interpenetration and intrapenetration and exopenetration, parapenetration. We know that we are made up of hard matter and we are hindered by these type of obstacles like this wall, this glass, various things are there. So to cross those things, that is known as parapenetration. We can enter into any body, we can cross any hindrance or obstacle, and we can deeply enter into any more person, or we can hold any person's internal structure inside us. These things are very great skills which have been told in the Shastras. Intrapenetration, interpenetration, parapenetration, intra-assimilation, inter-assimilation, psychokinesis, pervasion, simultaneous presence in various places. So it is a special physics, paraparticle physics. When I am telling about these type of things to physician and physicist. The physicist deals with the rules of physics and physician deals with the rules of the physical body and understanding the bodily movements. Then generally I told that there are two things in science. One is grade and second thing is discipline. Everything is in science, but there is a difference in grade and discipline. For example, if I want to know about, for example, some law, that is Fleming's rule, then I must go into physics. If I see the search or try to see the same in mathematics, I cannot get it. That is also a science. If I want to see that in biology, I cannot get that. If I want to see the function of your heart in physics, I cannot get it because of the discipline variation. And grade variation, if I want to understand, for example, integral calculus or differential calculus, I cannot get it in the third standard mathematics book. That is grade variation. Everything is in science, but you have to look for that specific science that deals with that, especially to that grade which deals with that particular thing. So it is known as proper approach of grade and discipline. Likewise, they told that, somebody told, if something is done there, do you just to mean that those things are against nature or physics, then I told that they are not against nature, they are special rules of nature. The exploitation of nature is done by only human beings. All energy and power resources are special rules or exemptions of nature. As a equally regulations and exemptions. We have seen that there is electricity and it will charge our body. That is a rule. And if a person wears rubber gloves, rubber does not conduct electricity, so the person will not be harmed. That is not against the rule of electricity, but that is a special rule of non-conductivity whereby the person takes the charge of the charge, controls it and does the work properly. So this is how we can understand. No rule that is as per philosophy, religion, spiritualism that is meant for the society, no rule is against nature. They are special provisions of nature, exemptions of nature which are incorporated within the nucleus of the nature itself. It is paranatural things are not anti-natural. Lot of these artificial inventions are seriously this biodegradation, exploitation, these things are anti-natural. The science which is claiming to preserve nature, these things are indulging in lot of anti-things. Para is entirely different from anti. So these type of forces are there. The pervasion or permeation is vyapti, yugavat sannidhi, simultaneously being present in various things. And the sixth thing is possession, niyantrana. A person having distant possession is there. Inhibited possession is also there. Possession is of four types. There is what we call achyavatara avesha, archa samadhi ullangana, bhagavad avesha. We used to read it in scriptures and hagiographic treatises that God permeated inside some specially gifted personality and revealed lot of truths. That is known as a divine possession. That may be transient, occasional or permanent. And second thing is celestial possession, in which devatas they used to occupy. Then demonic possession, wherein by lot of deities, goblins and other structures they used to occupy. Then devilish possession of paishashas and other things. We are seeing lot of fictions and lot of people are behaving worse than deity's possession with normal human possession itself. So he used to experience these things better than my experience. So this is known as possession. Then there is revelation. Apart from possession, revelation. Yes, the Divya Prabandha is a revelation. Each and every people, each and every religious person or community, they are proud to say that their scriptures are revelations and the revelators or the revealers are the authenticated prophets or the lineage of that, and anybody contradicting that thing is not authenticated and this is the last of the lineage and nobody is going to come further to change all of this thing. It has become the total dogmatic strand of each and every religious stipulation or narrow-mindedness. It has become that. So revelation is also there. Apart from possession, for a purpose, possession for a long-term or mass that gives some sort of benefit to the society is known as revelation of ideas, either in the form of scriptures or in the form of spiritual messages. These things are known as various other things. And also in mani mantra, we used to have manis, lot of the gems are there. According to our gems, they are just decorative, they are just very expensive, they are looking royal, and that shows the status of our richness, apart from which they have a lot of other healing qualities and mind setup qualities and lot of other things. Lot of lights are being thrown by lot of people, that is interesting. That is all I study. And the study of mantra is very much important. That is known as photosynthesis. That type of things that is having a highly sophisticated order, that is order of ad infinitum and ultimatum, that which is having the ultimate sophisticated order beyond which you cannot create anything, that is known as mantra. Mantra is the utmost saturated point of perfection beyond which you cannot commit anything to that. The second thing is that order or means of repetition that gains power. Number three, a person with proper regulatory principles, adoption and loyalty towards those things by belief and sincere execution, he becomes the qualified tool for exhibiting that power. Number one, first is the inherent power of the sophisticated order of mantras. Second is the power due to the repetitive recitation or ritualization. Third is the power of purity that is there within the reciter or the ritualizer or the person who corresponds with us by means of his austerity and spiritual practice and sincerity and belief. So there are three powers united to give the portions of the mantras to be efficacious really for all mankind's benefit and success and happiness. That is the mani mantra. Then prana pratishtha, they have been telling prana pratishtha. What is prana pratishtha? What is prana? Niyate anena iti
pranam. Pradarshayana niyate anayati pranam. The force, the basic immanent force that leads everything, that is known as pranam. That is immanent in everybody, even this as pranam. But what is the difference between your prana and this prana? This prana is subjective prana and it is a receptive prana, receptive consciousness. Now the global consciousness project, they have revealed that each and every project or product is the output of consciousness. There is consciousness in each and everything. In higher people like human beings, the consciousness is mature. We are seeing lack of people in human beings worse than trees. Why can't that be an assumption? Or a contemplative study of a permutation possibility where trees are more intellectual than human beings, which may be available in exobiotic studies, available in some other planets or something else. So, like this, even in the infra species, even in the insentient beings, that is prana. But the prana that requires a potential, the potential, and also some compatibility. Somebody told them, why can't you offer this beef to God? God resides everywhere. Why can't you offer this? Then we told that. Very simple. We can offer to God because God resides in meat, and while he is consuming the whole world at a time of dissolution, he is not avoiding this non-vegetarian creatures. All species are swallowed at the time of cosmic dissolution. You can give this thing as an offering to God, and God can also instill his blessings. But it is not a good conductor compatible to divine charge and its transmission. You can give, like I told, four conductors, bad conductors, semiconductors, conductors, hyperconductors. We used to study in the conductor study in physics. Likewise, that can be offered to God, but he wants to give his message to us. That is not a good transmitter, that is not a good conductor. So we cannot do that. So likewise, this type of understanding the basic principles that removes a lot of hurdles in spiritual realization. So here, this paranormalism, in understanding about the mantras is very much important, because in upasana, in japa, in tapa, in havana, in pujana, in mandira, in shraddha, in upanayana and other samskaras, everywhere we are glorified with mantras. We are given, we have been given a lot of mantras. So unless we understand the phonosynthesis, like the work of photons, it is the work of phonons. It is a proper order I have told, and also by repetitive and analytical scrutiny, and also by the person's blemishless loyalty and sincerity in practice, mantras are really very beneficial. So each and everything is having its own life prana, and the prana can be induced only by special forces. We cannot do it with ordinary forces. We can do it with a lot of forces. The special thing, what is a mantra? Somebody told, how can you very simply put Vedas? I told that it is the most sophisticated information and communication technology. We cannot understand about the celestials or the forces behind the nature. We cannot understand the God who is behind the deities and forces. Information about those things is given only by these Vedas. Second thing is communication. Namaste Vayu, O wind, I worship you. Nathe Vishnu Jayamano Najato Deva Mahina Paramanta Mata. O Vishnu, you are very great and nobody is equal to you. Agne Naya Subhataraye. Hey Agni, please lead me in your noble path. So it is a communication technology. Vedas are information technology about the unseen or invisible forces of nature, celestial forces behind nature, the divine forces behind the celestials. And also it provides you the proper way of communication. That is the greatness. That is known as Prana Pratishta. If you do that Prana Pratishta, immediately the already existing consciousness is induced. As it is induced, for example, somebody asked, why you are doing samprokshana and we are doing lot of other things. Then immediately I told, there need not be a switch or regulator for the cosmic electricity or magnetism. Whenever you tap and pull it for your use, that limited thing, you are taking a part of affinity from that infinity for your application, that has a switch to on, to off and to regulate. That does not mean that the whole electric system can be just regulated like that. Likewise, even if you store that energy by means of a practice on agamas, shraddha, bhakti, vishwasa, etc., then that requires a proper process of installation, then rejuvenation, recycling, all these processes are required for the stored energy. So prana pratishta is very much essential, and the prana pratishta is also a paranormal phenomenon. Understanding all of the non-living beings as having a living consciousness inside, which can be induced only by mantras, which cannot be brought by anything else. Ananya Sadhya, that cannot be contributed by anything else. That's why it has made its vyapti in the temples. In the form of Moola, Utsava, Bhogabhera, Balibhera, Yagabhera, Shayanabhera, Gopura, Vimana, Dvajastambha, Balipita, Avarna, Stalavriksha and Pushkarani. They are known as Trayodashangas of temples. That the energy is permeated into various other forms which must have been told in the temple lecture that we can decide later. So this prana pratishtha, it is also somebody told Vedas are nanotechnology or not. Then I told the nanotechnology as specification. After nanotechnology, after 10 years, there may be a picotechnology, after technology, some technology may come. Nanotechnology is specified. That is a centi, milli, micro, 10 to the power of minus 14 means it is specified. And whatever we call a subtlety, that is anor aniyan, I gave an explanation, which is told in the Shastras. You take one anu, and you take this universe. You make a proportional ratio. The ratio that exists between this single atom and this whole macrocosmic entity, the same you put in the negative integer on that side, making this, for example, if it is 1 is to 1000, you make the 1000 part of this to be put in the other side of negative integer, and that will be the status of the subtlety of God. Even that is not capable of explaining the real status of the subtlety of God. So, the proportion of the macroscopic expansion of the universe in comparison with the subtlest atom, even a subatomic particle, in the negative integer side, the same proportion is put as a comparative substratum for the other side, that will be the subtlety of God. So, the nanotechnology, it has some sense of understanding of utility of the basic particles in medicine and other applications. The same thing, for example, if somebody is giving teertham, the temple teertham is given. That is more than nanotechnology. In the subtler than the subtlest part of the teertham, the energy that is inhibited by the Agya, Padya, Achamaniya and various other sacerdotal rites that have been performed in the temple, that is mixed in the Sarvartha Goya, which is then distributed for the people for that benefit. So, nanotechnology is specific. And this thing is not like that. These things are very infinitely infinitesimal. That is a certainty status of God. Next, we have to come to the Ashtama Siddhis of our people. That is Marana, force of destruction. There are innumerable types of Maranas. Petrification. Ash reduction is there. Petrification is there. Ash reduction is there. Disintegration is there. Conversion is there, immobilization is there. Innumerable siddhis are there in Marana. The two Bhuta Marana, Desha Marana, Raja Marana, Stri Marana, Mrigha Marana, Pakshi Marana, Paishaja Marana, innumerable Maranas are there. Then there is Mohana. Mohana is alluration. Captivation is known as Vashya. Fixation is known as Stambhana. Intrusion is known as Vedana. Procuration is known as Akrushna, to create something. Or to replace something, or to convert or demorphose or metamorphose something, or to bring something from a greater distance, to place in the exchange about the articles available here and needed. All of these things are in Akrushana. Uchatana is instigation, and Vitveshana is insight. So, all of these things are there in our Shastras also. And the miniaturization is known as Hima, macroscopism is known as Mahima. Mass reduction is known as Laghima, mass induction is known as Garima, Prapti is known as Siddhi, accomplishment. Then Prakamya is known as uninterrupted desire and execution. Ishitva is known as control, Pashitva is known as alienation of all entities, subservience of entities. So all of these skills are there. But those things, see, whenever we have to read something, whether it is a time pass or recreation or creation, that must be the nature of the confidence that we have to understand. We are talking about history. We learn something from history and apply for contemporary studies and futuristics. We see about dinosaurs and other things. Those things are just records that those things existed. Or all of these paranormal phenomena are just records of the past, which may not be practically implemented now. What is the use of us knowing? Can we practice something? Are somebody practicing all of these things? Can we be initiated and practice something? What is the role of energy in modern universe? What is the role of these things in the modern universe? It's challenges, hopes and demands. All of these questions are necessary to be put at the time of dealing about a concept and at the time of conclusion. Apart from all of these various things, I put it in the conclusion, there are some other things also, astrology, Vastu. See, we are seeing lot of planets. Somebody asked from the National Observatory, if you want to get a nakshatra, a constellation, to send its ray or radiation to reach a person on Earth, it will take several light years. Then these constellations, 27 galaxies are going to affect you, and what is the purpose of zodiac? So he is a very great predecessor in astrology, predictive astrology. Predictive astrology, it is not on spatial astrology, astronomy, astrophysics or something else. He believes in terrestrial and celestial engineering. But he is against the predictive or influential study of these things. Then what we want to say, there are two vyavaharas. One is manasika, second is prakritika. For example, if you want to go to London, it will take so many hours in flight. If you go by walk, I don't know how many months it will take. Then if you think from your reminiscences or from a picture or from somebody's recollection of experiences, you can immediately travel. So, taijasika and prakritika are the two modes of travel. If there is a prakritika travel of these constellations or these planets, it may take some light years, but it is the taijasa by the tejas. The planets, they do have some tejas, and the tejas, they have a different speed rate, which is not very much equivalent or equiambiguous with that of this light year travel, which is mentioned in astronomy. Well, there are different other things which are nothing but compromise and compensations if they are not without scientific base and explanations. And Vastu is there, it is also one science. Witchcraft is there, black magic is there. Other people, they used to ask a lot of questions. What about materialization? I want to tell just few things about materialization. Apurvata, Anupalabdhi, Vilakshana, there are some qualities for materialization. If somebody materializes something, for example, somebody is giving you kumkuma, that is not anupalabdhi. He can purchase this anywhere else, but to create some belief or to make a person to be brought to his own root, he may be doing that. Anupalabdhi means that must not be available anywhere. Apurvata, which is available, but this thing is distinguishable. For example, it takes daily a color and fragrance, that kumkum. Then that is apurvata. Then vilakshana means it is keeping on showering, or it is keeping on giving some sort of benefit which is different from other things. So different from other things, distinguishable from other things, not totally available. Like that, there are lot of other things. And also in Uttama, Madhyama and Adhama, Vanchita, Ishta, Chintita is to say. If somebody materializes something as per his desire, that there is no Ishta, that is Adhama. If I am able to give anything you ask, that is known as Madhyama. You need not ask. If you think if I am ready to give immediately, that is known as Uttama Siddhi. And moreover than that, then that is Hastagrahya, Hastagrahya, Parahastagrahya, Swagastam Drutha. These things are the various types of siddhis told in Shastras. If I create something within me, within my hand or within my position, that is Adhama. If I can create something in you, that is known as Uttama. If something is Hastagrahya, that which is very easily handleable within your capturation, that is inferior. If something is far beyond you, somebody is giving a pumpkin, they need pumpkin. That is a very great siddhi. So Hasta Agrahya. So a lot of other siddhis are there. They must be necessarily studied for various reasons which I am going to. Now let us come to the final point. In oral skills, intellectual skills and physical skills are powers, paranormal. What are the physical paranormal thing? Number one is fortification. Nainam chindanti shastrani. Nainam dhati bhavakaha, nachainam kledayam tyapaha, asoshayati maharata. These things are there in Gita. It is only for soul, not for body. If a person has fortification, he finds seasonal, climatic and natural forces and their impact. From thunder, from lightning, from water, from fire, from poison, mantra, yantra, tantra, visha, abhichara, sunni, astra, sastra. All of these things are totally supportive to the person. Person will just consume everything as bone meat or boost. That is known as fortification. And second thing is trance. A person who is in samadhi, even though it is not a physical phenomenon, that gives us physical stability. A person in trance, divine trance, it may be mobile trance or immobile trance. One Sadashiva Brahmendra, he was just walking. One rogue was there waiting on the way, and he just ridiculed the person, and carelessly he was just moving. And immediately, because this fellow with a very big knife, he went there and ridiculed once more, and he did not respond. Immediately he cut off the arm of this Sadashiva. He thought, mind, he was just singing and moving. Then what he is going to do with that cut arm, which is bloodshedding in his hands? Immediately the fellow got trembling and shivering fear, And he informed the Sadashiv Gurumendra that his arm has been very honestly, systematically amputated by the rogue. He has confessed. Then Sadashiv Gurumendra, he did not say anything. Just keep it and go away. Okay, sorry. Thank you. So he just kept and he was going there. It is a moment trance. And those who are in immobile trance, for them also, why I am saying this, even though trance is a spiritual attribute, a person in deepest spiritual attribute, for example, if I am having a good incense stick that will permeate the puja room, if it is more fragrant, it will permeate the whole room. If somebody is cooking something with spice or something, the whole street will be made spicy and juicy. Likewise, it is not a permeation. Quality of eternity and undisturbability is an attribute of soul, not body. Whenever the spiritual progress is more, this quality permeates to the body also. The body is equally imperishable as the soul. And you know that the Nainam Chintanti Shastrani, Nainam Dahate Pavakah, it is for soul. But for Prahlada, when he was harassed by his parents, by his father, then he was just targeted with missiles, he was put into fire. All of these treatments have been for his body. But it did not work out. Even though the spiritualistic attitudes are different, in over spiritual progress and realization, the attitudes are permeating, they are overlapping in the body also. So this also, so it is known as benefit of trance. And third is elixir. It may be aushada or anaushada. It may be due to some medicines, or even without any medicines, youth, energy and longevity is known as elixir, kalpa. Those who are having kalpa sharira, they have perennial youth, perennial dynamism and disease freeness and also longevity, extended longevity. So these things are physical paranormal phenomena. Then what is oral paranormal phenomena? We are seeing lot of things like benediction. What is a blessing? Potential wish of a person passed to a sincere, able and compatible receptor is known as benediction. And malediction is a curse, which is known as evil eye, etc. I have already told in one lecture that even if your parents, it won't work out. Because parents and their instinctive attachment towards the children's progress is naturally common with cockroach, rats, everybody, etc. So unless the parents, they have penance, austerity, honesty and good attributes, the attributes along with their wish, potential wish is known as blessing. Mere wish or desire or expectation, dream is not blessing. So, merely elders, or mere parents, or merely red scholars, without having potentiality of or sincerity, their mere wishes are ineffective. So, malediction, benediction, these things are oral. Apart from this, who is that? Apart from this, there are also some great skills, intellectual skills, which we want to say now. Number one is prognostication. Predictive understanding. There is a cosmic rhythm, and there is a cosmic way of code. Each and every happening is connected with a code, series of actions. That may be irregular, but the irregularity is regular. Somebody asked whether the code of the world is regular. I told that it may be irregular, but the irregularity is regular. It is regularly irregular, so there is a constancy. Understanding this code and the process of deciphering and divulging the same thing for apprehension, application, and you know, prognostication. Clairvoyance is time travel, time understanding, and also incidental understanding and causative understanding. Traveling with the tenses, traveling with tenses, traveling with the causative factors, and traveling with the incidental factors. So causative, incidental, and the tensile factors are moved in clairvoyance. Then there is also multi-level adaption, adapting various things. In Sanskrit, we used to say it as bahubhashini, sambhashini, vibhashini, subhashini. Polylingualism is a person simultaneously can speak in any language, speaks about the language. Polydimensionalism is any type of faculty, any type of thing he can understand and he can speak. And polylevel understanding is any level of depth he can go to the subject. And polylingualism is entirely different from multilingualism. If you speak different languages, that is different from a person speaking the same language, but that is heard by different people in different languages. So there are innumerable skills are there. They are just for record. They are not for a demonstration, experimentation, practice, show, exhibition, etc. Those are skills are there. Intellectual skills. Then oral skills I have already told, the power of words. Now let us come to the conclusion. What is the purpose of reading all of these things? Before coming to the purpose, there are three paranormal phenomena I want to say. One is special, second is salient, third is specific. This universe, its creation, the celestial, the rishis, the liberation, hell, heaven, all of these things are sali. Those things are far beyond the reach of our immediate necessity and purpose. Let it be silent, let to read that, recognize it, realize it, relish it, or leave it. The second thing is special, that is healing. Healing comes out of that. There are a lot of healings, like face healing, psychic surgery, touch healing, subjective healing, distant healing, energy healing, abundance healing. There are innumerable healing systems, hundreds of healing systems are there. No materials are without any materials. So these things are very much useful for us. Specific paranormal phenomena is there to gain knowledge, to gain good relations, to gain betterment in life. There are a lot of other things. So those things are possible by what is normal. If you work, you are getting the benefits. It is normal. Even if you work, you won't be getting the benefits, or somebody else will get your benefits, or some previous act of yourself will intrude in the process of getting that. Or your normal execution or your normal skill is insufficient. So get the support of the paranormal, support of the lineage of God, godly, God sent, and divine institutional lineage, Acharya Parampara, by means of which sincere loyalty, resignation, worship, commitment, sharing, compassion, service, all of these qualities will make you a good paranormal receptor, the blessings of the divine person, which can be applied for your betterment. Specific, let us forget about social and salary. So paranormalcy, one third is applicable and needed by the society even now. Wherever there is atrocity, wherever there is irreligiosity, wherever there is abnormality in the society due to political imbalances, economical imbalances, like inflation, etc., then social disharmony in the form of communal and religious clashes. Certainly we have to pray only to the divine authority to function immediately to reinstall and to replace this demonic enthronements in the place of which there must be sadhatmas, there must be real truth for you. So six reasons are there for us to understand paranormal phenomena. Number one, we must, by understanding paranormal phenomena, we will have two things. We will have two type of things. One is fear, second is comfort. If there is something apart from normal, like the king is there, the rule is there, the legal system is there, judiciary is there, our neighbors are there, relatives are there. Apart from this, if there is paranormal, invisible vigilator who is governing us, who is all powerful and all knowing, we will have the fear of punishment. We will have the support of his encompassing embracement. To do something wrong, we will be having fear. And while we are depressed, if something is paranormal, if it is believed and properly, it is utilized by means of worship, suddenly we will feel that there is somebody to comfort us, there is somebody to support us. So understanding paranormalism, the first thing is fear of doing something wrong. And at the time of depression and distress, having the thought or having a strong belief and understanding of some divine support. The second thing is to understand what it is paranormal and normal, so that lot of the so-called paranormal people of the society and the fellows of the society can be filtered, can be understood in their limited levels. If somebody, for example, if there is a tailor, then he can stitch your cloth. It does not mean that he can do your surgery. So a person just bringing some paranormal things like kumkum, etc., or some other this inferior or filthy things, immediately they must not be thought as your philosophical guide and route for liberation. Understanding real paranormal phenomena that classifies all of these other people and their limitations also. A person who is a doctor, he need not be an engineer for you to construct your things. If a person removes diseases by his power, he is a healer. And healing is a force of God, which did not be God. I used to say always, the hair in the tip of the tail of an elephant is not an elephant. Likewise, this paranormal phenomena is to understood to understand the real divine energy from the so-called divine energies or pseudo-divine energies or even the semi-divine energies and the demonic energies. Often they are misapprehended and understood and approached. For that, a knowledge of distinguishing is possible by paranormal studies. And number three, to protect others and also to safeguard others, it is to be there. To develop this type of paranormal understanding, receptivity and even practice, it will be enabling us. And to create a better way of life, you are suffering due to loss. In physical body, we are suffering due to diseases and discomfort. In relations, there is a disharmony. And in all expectations, we are getting disappointment. We are getting appointments with disappointments, frustrations, etc. So in each and every walk of life, we used to get horses. either to totally avoid them or to limit them or to control or arrest them, at least to withstand them or even to get a reverberation or retrievability from those things, we require for a better life and better life settlement, a paranormal understanding and practice. And apart from all, for research, I have already told these things through that other paper, where there is anecdote, observation, experience, experimental and scriptural authorities. Only things have been told, there are two more things. These five things are to be researched and personally with people and also with the latest devices that are available for understanding the radiations and radiation variations at the time of various experience of people. For example, there is a cognitive research lab at the Department of Cognitive Sciences at Allahabad University, and there is the research center for consciousness management at Pish Pilani, that is sponsored by the ISKCON people. There are the latest equipment for understanding the variations that happen inside a person who is in depression, spiritual expression, realization, a mystic person, why pranayama, everything can be, output can be measured and systematically presented before the so-called rational, scientific and atheistic skeptic community to create a rational belief in the knowledge of our divinity, so as to make a balanced equilibrium of divine belief and understanding to create a fruitful and successful society. So for all of these reasons, we have to do these things. The end of the paranormal phenomena, I have just normally presented something about the paranormal phenomena, and it is just an opening, and on various occasions it needs a PowerPoint presentation, it needs demonstration, it needs lot of case studies, personal observations from various other healers and other people. I have already told experimentation, anecdote, then hearsay is anecdote. Then all of these things, they must be brought to a common platform in a second session, which must be more elaborative, elucidative and effective. Till then, I wish all of them to have a continuous zeal on this unquenchable subject of paranormal phenomena, and more persons who are there in the society who is often misled by these people. Always the people suffer due to misled rather than being properly led. And the Parihara Shastra is known as remedial mechanics or remedies. The first sutra says that the persons suffer due to lack of remedies rather than lack of remedies. He tells something, everybody directs to lack of things. So by doing lot of remedies, they just accumulate the troubles and disturbances. So do make an eye-opener to create a watchdog of the so-called religious paranormal society. You have to make a proper institution, then recognize everything, realize everything and put forward the same thing in society to lead them in a proper direction. Arana, arana.